Good morning. Our today's topic is Crotalus horridus, another snake poison, which although like NASA has proven only in low preparation, but it has a better clinical record. Crotalus produce profound nervous shock and prostration with trembling and in mind and disposition, disorganization, not only in mind, and in also circulatory system causing disorganization. Crotalus richly deserve proving in the potencies, Nash said. Crotalus richly deserve proving in the potencies in order to bring out its finer characteristics. Crotalus horridus, the medicine produced from rattlesnake, and effect of rattlesnake, if we are getting in literature, it is swelling, severe pain, tingling, anxiety and hemorrhage, rarely heart failure. If we consider the nature of toxin, the venom is mostly hemotoxic, causing destruction of skin and also affect circulatory system, causing hemorrhage. First regular proving of this poison are made by Herring and his fellow prover in first and second iteration, and it was published in monograph as effect of the poison in 1837. A single proving was recorded. It was done on an unmarried lady about 35 years. Actually, J.W. Hayward did the so far first and most complete record of the effect of Crotalus on human body. And he published his monograph in the year 1884. Now we are telling about the sphere of action, the circulatory system, mostly heart, blood, cerebrospinal system, liver, mostly those who are alcoholic, throat and right side. In any case of malignant jaundice also, it will act well. Person though have got bite of the snake and died, in those patients autopsy was done. And from autopsy we are getting some information. Very rapid and direct depressing influence on sensorium and medulla oblongata, and deranging both circulation. Actually, it is having influence on medulla oblongata. Autopsy found cortical substance of brain, membrane of brain in a state of engorgement with dark fluid, degraded blood, and cortex highly congested and stained a deep brown color. Seems to act primarily upon cerebrospinal nerve centers, producing secondary effect on decomposition of blood, destruction of blood fibrin, hemorrhage and ecchymosis. Affects principally the blood, the solar plexus, pneumogastric nerve and also the cerebrospinal system. Now if we consider the adaptability, generally indicated in debilitated hemorrhagic person, especially broken down constitution during zymotic disease. I will illustrate about zymosis later on. This term is repeatedly being used in this medicine, zymosis. Patient are deathly sick, disease caused by previous systemic effect of septic, typhoid, malarial fever or any other disease, chronic alcoholism, great prostration at such bleeding. A Crotalus is mostly right-sided. As we learnt earlier, Lacus is left-sided, Crotalus is right-sided. It is more hematic than hepatic, mind it. It is more hematic than hepatic. Yet there may be an element of both. Malignant disease with hemorrhage, any type of malignancy resulting hemorrhage Clotilla is a very beautiful medicine. Clotilla patient is readily moved to tears, weeping mood, with agony and despair. Now I am telling about the word zymotic, as this word is being repeatedly used in this medicine. This word has been used traditionally in pathology because of the concept of body being consumed and spoiled. As if in fermentation takes place for other things and decayed by any disease, if the body being consumed or spoiled, in old terminology, actually zymos is a term of 19th century, they termed as zymotic state. In recent terminology, we may call it sepsis, would be the similar expression. You all know, disease producing power is the disease curing power of every homeopathic medicine. So whenever we are going through any medicine from Materia Medica, generally we are getting proving records, clinical symptoms and some verified clinical symptoms in our Materia Medica, along with few toxicological symptoms also. But originally, the disease curing power of any medicine is being hidden in the disease producing power. For that reason, I do like to quote from prover's record. In one prover, perception was so clouded that she was in danger of being run over in the street, and memory was so impaired that on entering a shop, she forgot what she had come for. Another symptom was sleepy, but cannot sleep, and grinds teeth. Grinding of teeth during sleep is a very good and characteristic accompaniment of Clotilla ceridus. Grinding of teeth during sleep. As it is a proving records suggesting, it is also being clinically verified repeatedly. Hayward observed that slapping is a strong indication for Clotilla's, and the cure by this remedy of his own daughter of suffering from scarlatina with gangrenous looking sore throat was a dramatic outcome of his researches. Now I am sharing you about news, a patient having bite of rattlesnake. In the year 1892, it was published in newspaper by one doctor. Quote, "I was called to see James Wright, aged about 54 years, who while binding wheat in the paddy field actually, was bitten on third finger of right hand by a rattlesnake. I found him bleeding from bitten finger, from eyes, from nose, from ears, from mouth, even from rectum and urethra. Pulse was 110, small, respiration rate was 40, and temperature was 105. Haggard expression and whole body was bathed in hot perspiration, and also she was in delirium. Now we are coming the drug picture proper. First of all, appearance of the patient, generally besotted and anxious expression, pale, excited, maybe flushed also. Some patient may be very indifferent, apathetic attitude, paleness of face as if in faintness, livid, blotted, purple appearance in fair complexion, blue around sunken eyes, and death-like pallor. Now I am telling about the mind and disposition, the attitude of the patient. First of all, perception diminished. We got this symptom improving, diminished perception. Second is sadness, thoughts dwell on death continually. Memory is very weak, obtuse, stupid, cannot express him correctly, and makes ridiculous mistakes in spelling. Having weeping tendency with timidity, fear and anxiety. And if we consider temperament. They are snappish temper. Snappish means short-tempered. Became angry very easily from a tipples. Very irritable, cross, and infuriated by least annoyance. When get any stimulus to be angry, infuriated by least annoyance. Excessive sensitiveness and easily moved by tears, even whenever reading any novels, whenever enjoying any films. He is so sensitive in mental level, moved to tears. Another part is mental delusion, such as mistakes in keeping his accounts, in writing letters, forgetfulness about figures, names, places, and awaking in the night, struggling with imaginary foes. Someone is there, like that. Imagine himself surrounded by enemies, hideous animals, and also taking antipathies to members of the family. He or she is having family, having a feeling of antipathy to members of family. Mania of being injured from close neighbors, from relatives, in zymotic disease, when connected with mostly puerperial or ovario-uterine disease. So, if any female lives, those who are suffering from puerperial sepsis, along with having mental delusion, diminished perception, and mostly delusion, imagines himself surrounded by enemies, even family members become enemy, we may think of Prattala Sariras. Then particular symptom head, first I am telling about vertigo with faintness, with weakness and trembling, with pale face, epileptic. It may be epileptic in origin, it may be auditory in origin, even cardiac origin. Soft, weak pulse and better resting head, with venous congestion and degraded blood and dilated pupils. Fainting on assume upright position. So if he or she suddenly stand up from sitting position, a fainting tendency. And dizziness and fainting with occipital headache. Another very important symptom of Proteles, apoplectic convulsion at the onset of any zymotic disease, especially those who are alcoholics. In any acute severe infective disease, when it turns into convulsion, we may think for Crotillus. And if we get through MRI or CT scan, the hemorrhage in brain, zymosis, in any onset of zymotic disease, we may think for Crotillus. Awakens in morning with headache over eyes, extending to eyes, dull, heavy pain, heat over eyes, side of the nose, and bitter working in open ear. Severe pain in right eye, top of head, on right side down back neck at intervals. Once again I am reminding you, Crotillus Sariras is a right-sided remedy. While sitting in chair, heaviness of head came on so much that head felt as if it would tumble about, as if muscles of neck were too weak to support. It will be tumble about. And needed to the help of the hands. He is holding in heads like that. Dull, heavy, throbbing occipital headache, fainting spell. In selected cases, we may have violent itching on scalp also with eruptions. Headaches all over, with high fever, aggravation at night, great drowsiness. Even it may be accompanied with pains in bones, heat in forehead, frightful headache in diphtheria. It is being confirmed by constant hearing in clinical field. So, in any grave throat disease, if it be associated with headache and hemorrhagic manifestation from throat, we may think for Crotillus. It may not be diphtheria. Terrible headache, pain as from blow in the occiput. Another important beautiful symptom we are getting in Crotalus, patients those have been treated for toxemia or sepsis earlier, from typhoid, from chickenpox, from measles, even from dengue, even from corona, those have survived. After that, falling of hair. Falling of hair is after any zymotic disease is very good indication for Crotalus. I am telling about eyes. Already I have told is a very good hemorrhagic medicine. So in eyes we are getting hemorrhage into retina, whether occurring during course of retinitis and along with high albumin, ecchymosis, chemosis, conjunctival hemorrhage, especially in course of zymotic disease. Keep in mind actually, whatever symptom we are getting in Crotalus horridus, one hot part of the body it is developing, it is somehow or other is related with zymosis, that is sepsis. Illusion, blue colors, vanishing of sight while reading, blood exudes from eye, tearing, boring pain, and in malignant jaundice, the conjunctiva of the eye will be so yellow, on observation, a doctor may be anxious looking his or her eyes. Now I am telling about ear symptom, otorrhea. Otorrhea pass with blood, free using of blood. It also resulting from exanthema, menstrual irregularities, alcoholism, nasopharyngeal catarrh, diphtheria, typhoid, with full sensation in ears, deafness, illusion of hearing. And those who are suffering for a long time with chronic suppurative otitis media and characteristics manifestation of Crotalus, they may develop auditory vertigo. Then nose epistaxis at onset of during course of any zymotic or septic disease in a broken down constitution. Degraded, incoagulated blood. Degraded, incoagulated blood. Free flow of blood, dark blood with flashes of face and vertigo and fainting tendency. Now on face, acne of all varieties, especially history of masturbation and history of taking alcohol. Lips swollen, stiff, locked jaw, wakes up during night and grinding her teeth and face much distorted for getting repeated grinding of teeth during sleep almost in every night, face become distorted. In selected cases, mouth and nose drawn to left side. Copious ray teaching, papular eruption on face, especially on chin. Now today are concluding our first part of the lecture on Crotalus horridus. In next class, we will give in detail the rest part of Crotalus. Now you just observe the movement of rattlesnake, how it moves, and especially how the snake protrude her tongue. Please observe very minutely the attitude of the snake and especially how they protrude their tongues. Thanks all of you. Stay healthy.